Hello everyone, welcome to ComScholar. In this video, we will understand the basic difference between loan write-off and loan waive-off. Now, in the last month, RBI announced to write off 68,607 crore or 50 defaulters, and in this list, these people are also included, such as Nirav Modi, Mehul Choksi, Vijay Mallya, and so on. Now, first, let's understand the basic business operation of banks. Now, suppose this is X person and he has deposited some amount for some specific period in the form of FD, RD. And this person on an average earning at the rate of 6% per annum. Now, on the other hand, this Y person took some loan from this bank and the bank earning at the rate of 13% per annum from this person. Now, this differential rate of interest is basically the profit for the bank. Now, suppose this Y person fail to make payment on time, then after 90 days this person will be added in the defaulter list and this will become NPA, and it is also called bad loans. Now, after this, bank proceeds the provisions as per Indian Bankruptcy Code. As per this, bank has a right to sell off shares, property of the defaulter to recover the amount of loans. But sometimes banks fail to do so due to some reason, like sometimes defaulter run away from the country. As we have already seen in the cases of Nirav Modi, Vijay Mallya, and so on. So, after 3 quarters or 9 months, bank write off these NPA. Now let's understand why bank does so and what are their impacts. Now suppose, like, this is a balance sheet of a bank. This is a liability side and this is an asset side. Now all the loans and advances are to be write on asset side because bank need to recover all the loans from the debtors. Okay, and these loans and advances are converted into NPA, that is non-performing assets, or these are also known as bad loans. So what they do, after 3 quarters or 9 months, these NPA will be write off or will be written in the expense side of the P&L account. Why does bank so? The biggest impact of to do this is bank will pay less tax. How? As you already know, tax basically pay on the profit. Now if the bank write all the NPA on the expenses, the profit will get down and then bank will pay less tax. So basically, when the NPA is to be written on expenses side of the P&L account, this procedure is called write-off. Now move to loan waive-off. What is the meaning of loan waive-off? Now suppose bank give some loans to the farmers and they fail to make payment on time. So after 90 days, these loans will become NPA. Now, in this case, there are very less chance to recover these NPA from the farmers by selling off their properties. So, bank will intervene for the welfare of the farmers and they make payment to the bank. This procedure is called loan waive-off. In Hindi, it is called karz maafi. Okay, so that means For the welfare of the farmers, government will make all the payment of NPA. So these are the basic difference between loan written off or write off and loan waive off. I hope you understand this concept very well. Thank you. Please keep like and subscribe my channel.